Hello, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. Last left off, ended up stuck between a decision between... I mean, stuck in a decision between the clinically depressed childhood friend and the shy girl who quite possibly self-harms. And after much deliberation, if I'm going to have to pick sides here, yes, seniority wins out. One I've known longest is the one I'm going to have to be going with. So, yeah. Hope this doesn't have any negative repercussions, as it most likely will. Eh? Those are my true feelings. So, there's no way you could like me more than I like you. Should've realized it sooner. But spending time with everyone at the club, making new friends, and having fun with you every day, it helped me realize that you truly are the most important person to me. So I'll accept any of your burdens. As long as we could continue like this every day, with you by my side. Then I know we'll both be happy. Lydic. Yeah, I... Holy shit, I have a back of the head. I get the feeling that this is going to go wrong in every conceivable way. Suddenly, Sayori wraps her arms tightly around me. Lydic. Is this really okay? Yeah. I hold Sayori in my arms and pull her closer. You'll never have to let go of me again. Love you. I love you, Lydic. I want to be with you forever. Me too. I want to be with me too. God damn it. I feel Sayori's grip around me weaken a little bit. What is this, Sayori? Supposed to be happy right now. I kind of figured. I always thought this would be the happiest moment for me. But why? Even now? Why won't the rain clouds go away? They're not going away at all, Lydic. It's okay, Sayori. It might take some time for things to get better again. But no matter how long it takes, I'll be there every step of the way. It's all that matters right now.
Oh. Okay, I trust you.
Oh god, I'm gonna get fucking stabbed by Yuri.
Or you're gonna get stabbed by Yuri. Someone's getting stabbed by Yuri. Sayori and I slowly release each other. So, I guess that makes the festival tomorrow our first date, huh?
What are you saying? I don't want to think about those things, you know? I want everything to be the same as it always has been. Even if we really are a couple. I don't know if I could handle anything more right now. It's really new and scary to me.
I understand. Christ, this is... Everything is going to go wrong. Everything is going to go wrong. I just... A storm's coming. We'll go at whatever pace suits you best.
Hey, Lydic?
Sayori gazes at me, once again, smiling sadly.
Even if I get really, really sad, this is the best thing for me, right?
Oh boy. I don't really understand what Sayori means by that.
Are you saying that this is making you feel sad, Sayori? I don't know. I don't understand what I'm feeling.
It feels like a bunch of thorns when you told me you love me. But that's why I want to trust you.
Fuck. You know what's best for me. Jesus, fuck.
I don't know what's best for anyone. Yeah. I do. That's my promise. I say that, but in reality, I've never felt more uncertain when it comes to Sayori. I know that I love her, and she loves me. But I'm having as much trouble understanding Sayori's feelings as she is. Even though I can comfort her. I keep wondering if I should be doing something more, or something different. I know these thoughts will continue to plague me until things are back to the way they were. Is this what Sayori meant by not wanting anything to change? I don't know. But I know that I'll give it everything I've got.
Is she taking medication for this, or?
Like, prescription medication, not like that shit they advertise on TV that could actually turn you psychotic. Sayori is the most important person to me. And I'll do whatever it takes to have a happy future with her.
I am so getting stabbed.
It's the day of the festival. Of all days, I expect this to be the one where I'm walking to school with Sayori. But Sayori isn't answering her phone. Ah, shit. I consider going to her house to wake her up, but decided that's a little too much. Meanwhile, the preparations for the event should be nearly complete. The banner Yuri and I painted is dry, and I gently rolled it up to take with me. She sent me a pleasant text reminding me not to forget anything, and I reassured her. Funnily enough, I probably feel the same way about Natsuki about the event. I'm more excited for it to be over so I can spend time with Sayori and Yuri at the festival. But knowing Monika, I'm sure the event will be great too.
Why is there no music?
Lydic, you're the first one here. Thanks for being early. That's funny. I thought at least Yuri would be here by now. Monika is placing little booklets on each of the desks in the classroom. It must be the ones she prepared that has all the poems we're performing. In the end, I found a random poem online that I thought Monika would like and submitted it. So that's the one I'll be performing. Didn't write one yourself this time?
I'm surprised you didn't bring Sayori with you.
Yeah, she overslept again. Dummy.
You'd think on days this important she'd try a little harder.
I say that, but I suddenly remember what Sayori told me yesterday. And suddenly I feel awful, knowing it's not that simple for her. I only said it because that's the way I'm used to thinking, but maybe I should have gone to wake her up after all.
You should take a little responsibility for her, Lydic. I mean, especially after your exchange with her yesterday. You kinda left her hanging this morning, you know?
Exchange? Monika, you know about that.
Of course I do. I'm the club president after all. Why?
That doesn't explain anything. But, I stammer, embarrassed. Did Sayori really tell her about it that quickly? That we're a couple now? I didn't really plan on bringing it up with anyone yet.
Jeez.
I don't know the full story at all, so don't worry.
I probably know a lot more than you think.
Monika is being just as friendly as ever, but for some reason I felt a chill down my spine after hearing that.
Hey, you want to check out the pamphlets? They came out really nice.
Yeah, sure. Grab one of the pamphlets laid out on the desks.
Oh, yeah, they really did.
Something like this will definitely help people take the club more seriously.
The fact that there's no music is really... ugh.
Yeah, I thought so too. I flipped through the pages. Each member's poem is neatly printed on its own page, giving it an almost professional feel. I recognize Natsuki and Yuri's poems from the ones they performed during our practice. What's this? Flip to Sayori's poem. It's different from the one she practiced. It's one that I haven't read before.
Oh!
Percent sign. Get out of my head, 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 get out of my head. Get out of my head before I do what I know is best for you. Get out of my head before I listen to everything she said to me. Get out of my head before I show you how much I love you. Get out of my head before I finish writing this poem. But a poem is never actually finished. It just stops moving.
Oh! this? Reading the poem, I get a pit in my stomach.
Oh boy.
Lydic? What's wrong? Nothing. This poem feels completely different from everything else Sayori's written.
Okay, choosing her, bad idea.
More than that, I changed my mind. I'm going to go get Sayori, so... Well, alright. Try not to take too long, okay? They quickly leave the classroom. Don't strain yourself. Monika calls out after me. I quicken my pace.
What was I thinking? I should have tried a little bit harder for Sayori.
It's not a big deal at least to wait for her, to help her wake up. Even the simple gesture of walking her to school makes her really happy. Besides, I told you yesterday that things will be the same as they've always been. It's all she needs, and all I want to give to her.
Oh.
I reach Sayori's house and knock on the door. I didn't expect an answer since she's not picking up her phone either. Like yesterday, I opened the door and let myself in. Sayori? She really is a heavy sleeper.
Oh boy.
I swallow. I can't believe I ended up doing this after all. Waking her up in her own house really is something that a boyfriend would do, isn't it? Well, I mean, if they're a walking distance, I guess. In any case, it just feels right. Outside Sayori's room, I knock on her door. Sayori? Pick up, dummy. There's no response. I really did not want to have to enter her room like this. Isn't it kind of a breach of privacy? But she really leaves me no choice. I gently open the door. Say, oh, fuck! Oh, God! An exception has occurred. File line... Oh! What the hell? Is this a nightmare? It has to be. This isn't real. There's no way this can be real. Sayori wouldn't do this. I don't know. Everything was normal until a few days ago. That's why I can't believe what my eyes are showing me. I suppress the urge to vomit. The fucking theme in the background! Just yesterday, I told Sayori I would be there for her. I told her I know what's best and that everything will be okay. Then why? Why would she do this? Oh God! How could I be so helpless? What did I do wrong? Confessing to her? I shouldn't have confessed to her. It's not what Sayori needed at all. She even told me how painful it is for others to care about her. Jesus, fuck. Ugh. Then why did I confess to her and make her feel even worse? Why did I do that? What? Oh, God. Why was I so selfish? This is my fault. I swear my thoughts keep telling me everything I could have done to prevent this. If I had just spent more time with her, walked her to school, and remained friends with her like it had always been... It was right there. Then I could have prevented this. I know I could have prevented this. Screw the literature club. Screw the festival. I just lost my best friend. Someone I grew up with. She's gone forever now. Nothing I do can bring her back. This isn't some game where I could reset and try something different. I only had one chance and I wasn't careful enough. Now I'll carry this guilt with me until I die. Nothing in my life is worth more than hers. But I still couldn't do what she needed from me. And now, I can never take it back. Never. 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 Oh, fuck!
looks like we found Sayori's ending. Also, Monica, dick move. You really left her hanging. God damn it. Okay, let's... Fuck it.
Error, character Sayori dot... File is missing or corrupt.
Oh! Oh! Does that mean she won't be there? Oh, jeez! Not sure why I reacted like that, it just... I see an annoying girl running towards me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is... my neighbor, a good friend since we were children. You know, the kind of friend you never see yourself making today, but just kind of works out because you've known each other for so long? We used to walk together on days like this. Starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently, and I would get tired of waiting up. But if she's going to chase after me like this, I'd feel better off running away. However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let... or catch up to me. Okay, it... It displayed a specific line of text, line of code. So... I'm gonna do... is... Doof! That was a mistake. In order to school to... use the worth being surrounded by couples of friend groups of school... Meanwhile, I've always walked to school alone. Oh! Oh!
I always tell myself it's always... it's about time I meet some girls or something like that. But I still have no motivation to join any clubs. She just straight up no longer exists. I'm perfectly content on getting by on the average while spending my free time on games and anime. There's always the anime club, but it's not like there would be any girls in it anyway. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I pack my things, I stare blankly at the wall for looking for an ounce of motivation. Clubs. There really aren't any that interest me. Besides, most of them will probably be too demanding for me to want to deal with. Guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club.
Oh!
Monica!
Oh! Oh my goodness, I totally didn't expect to see you here. It's been a while, right? Yeah, it has. I'm gonna keep going with what's going on right now, because I'm really scared about where this is leading.
Monica smiles sweetly. We do know each other. Well, we rarely talk, but we were in the same class last year. Monica is probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful, athletic.
Basically completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little...
Why did you come in here? Oh, what did you come in here for today?
Oh, I've just been looking for some supplies to use for my club.
Do you know if there's any construction paper in here? Or markers?
I guess you could check the closet. You're in the debate club, right?
About that. I actually quit the debate club.
Really? You quit?
Yeah.
To be honest, I can't stand all the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. In that case, what club did you decide to join?
Actually, I'm starting a new one. The Literature Club.
Literature? That sounds kind of dull. How many members do you have so far?
It's kind of embarrassing, but there are only three of us so far. It's really hard to find new members for something that sounds so boring.
Well, I can see that.
But it's really not boring at all, you know? Literature could be anything. Reading, writing, poetry. I mean, one of my members even keeps her manga collection in the club room.
Wait, really?
Yeah, it's funny, right?
She always insists that manga is literature too.
Okay.
I mean, she's not wrong, I guess. And besides, member's a member, right?
Did Monica say she?
Hey, Leidic.
Are you by any chance still looking for a club to join?
I mean, I guess so, but...
In that case... Is there any chance you could do me a big favor? I won't ask you to join, but... If you could at very least visit my club, it would make me really happy.
Please?
Well, I guess I have no reason to refuse. Besides, how could I ever refuse someone like Monica?
This game!
I was thinking of, like, ending it with that ending, but no, I'm gonna keep going.
I get the feeling that it's possible to eliminate everyone.
Sure, I guess I could check it out.
Awesome! You're really sweet, Leidic, you know that? It's nothing, really.
Shall we go, then?
I'll look for the materials another time. They're more important.
Okay.
And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul to Monica and her irresistible smile. And her habit of staring directly into my soul. A section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third-year classes and activities. Monica, full of energy, swings open the classroom door.
I'm back! And I brought a guest with me.
What?
Eh? A guest?
Seriously? You brought a boy?
Way to kill the atmosphere. Don't be mean, Natsuki. Anyway, welcome to the club, Leidic. All words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls.
Yes, let's not focus on the fact that everything has gone photo negative, stuff has been glitching out, and Monica is staring directly into my soul again.
So, let me guess. You're Monica's boyfriend, right?
No, I'm not.
Natsuki? The girl with the sour attitude, whose name is apparently Natsuki, is the one I don't recognize.
Oh, you're kidding me.
When I don't recognize her small figure makes me think she's probably a first year.
Anyway, this is Natsuki, energetic as usual.
And this is Yuri, the vice president.
It's nice to meet you.
Yuri, who appears more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with someone like Natsuki.
Yeah, it's nice to meet both of you.
So I ran into Leidic in the club room, and he decided to come check out the club. Isn't that great? Wait, Monica? Didn't I tell you you need to let me know in advance before you brought anyone new?
So there's no cupcakes?
Okay. Shit. This is... Like, is this gonna be a whole thing where I can do the entire thing through again? Or is this just gonna... Because it's more or less entirely different because of the lack of Sayori. Like... But... Oh, God. No. I was going to... Well, you know...
Sorry.
I didn't forget that. I just happened to run into him.
In that case, I should at least make some tea, right?
Yeah, that would be great.
Why don't you come sit down, Leidic? Girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. Yuri walks to the corner of the room and opens the closet. Meanwhile, Monica and Natsuki sit across from each other. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Monica.
So, I know you didn't really plan on coming here. But we'll make sure you feel right at home, okay?
This
president of the literature club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone. I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet. It must be hard to start a new club. You could put it that way. Not many people are interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new. Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention, like literature. Yeah. You have to work hard to convince people you're both fun and worthwhile. But it makes school events, like the festival, that much more important. I'm confident that we can really grow this club before we graduate. Right, Natsuki? Well, I guess. Natsuki reluctantly agrees. Such different girls, all interested in the same goal. Monika must have worked really hard just to find these two. Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. So uncomfortable. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the teapot in the middle. You keep a whole tea set in the classroom? Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book? I guess. Don't let yourself get intimidated. Yuri's just trying to impress you.
Was she the one that said that last time?
That's not... Insulted, Yuri looks away. I meant
that, you know.
I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea.
I'm glad.
Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. So, Leidic, what kind of things do you like to read?
Okay, so this was... considering how little I've read in the past few days, I don't really have a good way of answering that. Manga, I mutter quietly to myself, half-joking. That catches Natsuki's attention. It looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet. Not much of a reader, I guess. Well, that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see. Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger. My favorite are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in a foreign world is equally impressive. Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
But I like a lot of things.
Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well.
Isn't it amazing how a writer could so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop?
Oh, you mean like what happened earlier?
Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately. I read a horror book once. I desperately grasp for something I can relate to at a minimal level. At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a rock.
Jesus fuck, I still don't...
I'd expect that from you, Yuri. It suits your personality.
Oh, is that so? Really, if a story makes me think or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down.
Surreal horror is often successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment.
I hate horror.
Oh, why is that?
Well, I just... Natsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second.
Never mind.
That's right, you usually write about cute things, don't you?
What?
What gives you that idea? You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting.
Looked like you were working on a poem called Don't Say It Out Loud! Give that back!
Fine. Natsuki, you write your own poems?
I guess sometimes.
Why do you care?
I think that's impressive. Why don't you share them sometime?
No.
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them.
Not a very confident writer yet. I understand how Natsuki feels. Sharing that level of writing takes more than just confidence.
I'm waiting for the shoe to flip. Or other shoe.
What the fuck is that saying?
Shoe to drop?
Foot to drop. Glove to drop.
The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. You must be willing to open up to your readers, exposing your vulnerabilities and showing you the deepest reaches of your heart. You have some experience, do you have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work, it'll set an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
Guess it's the same for Yuri.
We all sit in silence for a moment.
Hey, I just got an idea.
How about this?
Atsuki, you're a little quizzically a Monica.
It is so weird not having Sayori here.
Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. And next time we meet, we'll share them with each other. That way everyone is even. I mean, I thought it was a good idea. Well, I think you're right, Monica. We should probably start finding activities for all of us to participate in together. I did decide to take responsibility as vice president, after all. I need to do my best to nurture the club as well as its members. Besides, now that we have a new member, it seems like a good step for us to take. Do you agree as well, Eidek? Hold on, still one problem. What's that? Now that we've reached the most important topic, I bluntly come forth with what's been on my mind the entire time. I never said I would join this club. Monica may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have other clubs to look at, and, I lose my train of thought. All three girls stare back at me with dejected eyes. And Monica continues staring into my soul. But... Sorry, I thought... Huh. Eh? The girls exchange glances before Monica turns back to me. I guess I need to tell you the truth, Lydic. The thing is, we don't have enough members to form an official club. Makes sense. We need four. And I've been trying really, really hard to find new members. If we don't find one more before the festival, I'm defenseless against these three girls. How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's like this? I feel terrible for letting everyone down in this situation. And besides, the club itself seems pretty relaxed. So if writing poems is the price to pay to spend every day with these beautiful girls. Right. Okay, I've decided then. I'll join the literature club. One by one, the girls' eyes light up. Oh my goodness. Really? Do you really mean that, Lydic? Yeah. Could be fun, right? You really did scare me for a moment. I mean, if you just left after all this, I'd be super pissed. Lydic, I'm so happy. We could become an official club now. Thank you so much for this. You're really amazing. I'll do everything I can to give you a great time, okay? Thanks, I guess. Okay, everyone. I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assessment? Write a poem to bring to the next meeting so we can all share. Monica looks over at me once more. Lydic, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself. Yeah. Can I really impress Class Star Monica with my mediocre writing skills? I already feel the anxiety welling up inside me. Oh, I feel a lot worse than you do. Meanwhile, the girls continue to chit-chat as Yuri cleans up the tea set. I guess I'll be on my way then. Okay. I'll see you tomorrow then. I can't wait. With that, I depart the club room and make my way home. The whole way my mind wanders back and forth between the three girls. Atsuki, Yuri, and of course Monica. Will I really be happy spending every day after school in a literature club? Perhaps I will take... I'll have the chance to grow closer with one of these girls. Alright. Just need to make the most of my circumstances, and I'm sure good fortune will find me. I guess it starts with writing a poem tonight. Oh, God. You have unlocked a special poem. Would you like to read it? Oh! Today I cut my skin open for the first time. It was exhilarating. I think I understand how... feels. I'm supposed to be the responsible one, though. I still don't think I'll be doing it again, unless I decide to kill myself. I left a memento for the occasion below. Oh! That's not a poem!
I think I was right about Yuri. I've decided I'm going to do the endings for all three.
And possibly a secret ending if it happens or something like that. Because...
Jesus Christ, I...
Calm as her, bunny. Sticky. Imagination. Heaven sent mask. No.
Cause, I... Oh god, I honestly just want to see more what this game has to offer, cause... Nature.
Uncontrollable. Sorry about that, had a recording issue, but I'm back now. Where's death end up for now? Okay. Not... Nibble. Bouncy. Okay. Duh. And Marshmallow. Okay, so I didn't aim for her this time. What?
Hi again, Lydic. Glad to see you didn't run away from us. Ha ha ha.
Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but at least I'm keeping my word. I at least keep my word. Well, I'm back at the Literature Club. I was the last to come in, so everyone's already hanging out.
Don't say hey, what? Thanks for keeping your promise, Lydic. Please don't use the word hanging right now.
What is it too overwhelming of a commitment for you?
Shit. Making you dive headfirst in literature when you're not accustomed to it?
No!
Okay! Stop that! It can only take so much.
Oh, come on. Like he deserves any slack. You already had to be dragged here by Monica. I don't know if you plan to just come here and hang out or what, but if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it.
Monica? Monica! Monica, no! Certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps her manga collection in the club room.
What?
Oh, God. I know that probably should have been like, fuck, but fuck. That caught me off guard. Natsuki finds herself stuck between saying Monica and manga. Manga is literature.
Hopefully dejected.
Is the background tilting? I can't tell if it's always been at that angle.
Tsuki plops back into her seat.
Also, Yuri is... Her sprite's a lot taller than usual.
I'm sorry, Lydic. We'll make sure to put your comfort first, okay? Yuri shoots Natsuki a disappointed glance.
Anyway, now that you're in the club and all, perhaps you might have an interest in picking up a book to read?
Well, can't really say no either way. Like you said, I'm in this club now. I swear the guitar sounds off.
So it only feels right for me to do something like that if you ask. Is the background moving? I can't...
Wait. I didn't mean it like that. If you don't really want to, then forget I said anything, I guess.
No, it's not that, Yuri. I want to try to be part of this club. So even if I don't read often, I'd be happy to pick up a book if you wanted me to.
Are you sure? I just feel like, well, as vice president and all, that we should help you get started on something you might like.
Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book. I didn't want you to feel left out. So I picked out a book I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted.
How is this girl accidentally being so cute?
And why is
Her sprite's getting bigger. She even picked out a book she thinks I'll like despite me not reading much. Eerie, thank you. I'll definitely read this. I enthusiastically take the book. Whew.
Fuck.
Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think.
Okay.
Now that everyone's settled in, I expect Mana to kick off some scheduled activities for the club, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she's been like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki's rummaging around in the closet. Ugh. Hear Natsuki at her exasperated sigh within the closet. She seems to be annoyed by something. I approach her, in case she needs a hand.
Okay, so I am... So me deciding to stick more with Natsuki this time instead of Yuri is causing some different dialogue.
You looking for something in there? Fucking Monica! She never puts any of my stuff back in the right spot. What's the point of keeping your collection organized if someone else is just gonna mess it up? Natsuki slides a bunch of stacked books and boxes across the shelf. Manga? You read manga, right? Sometimes. Manga is one of those things where you can't admit you're really into it until you figure out where the other person stands. Kinda the same here. How did you know, anyway? I heard you bring it up at some point.
Besides, it's kinda written on your face.
What's that supposed to mean?
I see.
There's a lone volume of manga amidst the stacks of various books on the side of one of the shelves. The glitches on some of these are some that I hadn't seen before. Curious, I pull it out of the stack. Wait, was that initially going to be a reference to Sayori? Curiously, I pull it out of the stack. There it is! Natsuki snatches it out of my hand. She then turns to a box of manga and slips the volume right into the middle of the rest. Ah, much better. Seeing a box set with one book missing is one of the most irritating, it's probably the most irritating sight in the world. I know that feel. Get a close look at the box set she's admiring. Parfait Girls? It's a series I've never heard of in my life. Probably means it's either way on my demographic or it's simply terrible. I don't know, some of the ones that are... are in my wheelhouse are ones that are terrible. If you're gonna judge, you can do it through the glass on that door. She points to the classroom door. Hey, I wasn't judging or anything. I didn't even say anything. It was the tone of your voice. But I'll tell you one thing, Lydic. Consider this a lesson straight from the literature club. Don't judge a book!
This.
In fact, Natsuki pulls out the first volume of Parfait Girls from the box. I'm gonna show you exactly why. She shoves the book right into my hands. I stare at the cover. It features four girls in colorful attire, striking animated feminine poses. It's exceedingly moe. Well, I did watch a good portion of Is the Order a Rabbit, so fuck it. Don't just stand there. Natsuki grabs my arm and pulls me out of the closet. Finally, I'm free! She then takes a seat against the wall beneath the windowsills. She pats the ground next to her, signaling me to sit there. Wouldn't the chairs be more comfortable? I take my seat. Chairs wouldn't work. We can't read at the same time like that. Huh? Why is that? I guess it'd be easier to sit closer together like this. Don't just say that. It'll make me feel weird about it. Natsuki crosses her arms and scooches an inch away from me. Sorry. Didn't exactly expect to be sitting this close to her either. Not that I could say it's a particularly bad thing. I open the book. It's only a few seconds before Natsuki is once again inches closer, reclaiming the additional space while she hopes I don't notice. Feel her peering over my shoulder, much more eager to begin reading than I am. Wow, how long has it been since I read the beginning? You don't go back and flip through older volumes every now and then? Not really.
Maybe sometimes after I finish the series. Hey, are you paying attention? I am, but nothing's really happened yet, so I can talk at the same time. Looks like it's about a bunch of friends in high school. Typical slice of life affair. I kinda grew out of these, since it's rare for the writer to be entertaining enough to make up for the lack of a plot. Yeah, kinda. Okay! Fuck! Are you sure this isn't boring for you? It's not. Even though you're just watching me read. Well, I'm fine with that. If you say so. I guess it's fun sharing something you like with someone else. Anyway, wait. I always get excited when I convince my friends to pick up a series I enjoy. You know what I mean? Huh? Hmm. You don't? That's not... I wouldn't really know. What do you mean? Don't you share your manga with your friends? I mean, I share all sorts of things with my friends. I've gotten friends of mine hooked on Nostalgia Critic. Yet to get anyone hooked on Cinema Snob, though, sadly. Could you not rub it in? Oh, wait. Sorry, missed that line. It was, like, you don't have any friends or something. Jeez. Sorry. I could ever get my friends to read this. They just think manga is for kids. I can't bring it up without them being all like, eh, you still haven't grown out of that yet? Makes me want to punch them in the face. Ugh, I know those kinds of people. Honestly, it takes a lot of effort to find friends who won't judge, much less friends who are also into it. I'm already kind of a loser, so I guess I gravitated towards the other losers over time. I guess it's harder for someone like you. Huh? Yeah, that's pretty accurate. Wait, which part? You just called me a loser? I mean, I feel I can't even keep it up in my own room. I mean, keep it in my own room. What? My dad would beat the shit out of me if he found this? What the fuck? I guess it's safe here in the club room. Except Monica's kind of a jerk about it. I think we figured out what Natsuki's deal is. Ugh, I just can't win, can I? Well, paid off in the end, didn't it? I mean, here I am, reading it. Well, it's not like that solves any of my problems. Maybe. But at least you're enjoying yourself, right? So? Jeez, that's enough. Are you gonna keep reading or what? Yeah. I flipped the page. Time passes. Natsuki is strangely quiet now. I glance over at her. Looks like she started to fall asleep. Hey, Natsuki. Yeah? Suddenly Natsuki collapses straight into me. Hey. Oh, jeez. Natsuki, are you okay? I don't think she is! Here. Monica reaches into her bag and pulls out some kind of protein bar. She throws it at Natsuki's direction. Natsuki's eyes light up again. She snatches the bar from the floor and immediately tears off the wrapper. I told you not to give... Doesn't even finish her sentence before stuffing it into her face. Don't worry, Lydic. She's fine. Just happens every now and then. She diabetic? That's why I always keep a snack in my bag for her. I was like, was that a low blood sugar problem? I'm really worried. Anyway, why don't we all share poems now? Suki first. I told Natsuki I was interested in her poems yesterday. It's probably only fair I shared mine with her first. Okay, let's start with the things I don't like. First of all, Natsuki rereads my poem. Never mind, I don't feel like giving you my opinion. Eh? What's the point of sharing in the first place? I wrote this when I could have been doing other things. In fact, I remember you said you wanted... Remember how I said I wanted to read your poems? That's what I had in mind when writing this. I want to help you feel comfortable enough to share yours. Like Monica said... Well... I'd be more comfortable sharing my poems if yours was really bad. You were supposed to show me some dumb poem and make me go, ha!
Well, it's not that great, but let me show you what real literature looks like. And you went and ruined it. Hope you're happy. So, in other words, you're saying you liked it. Nah. Tsuki's retort gets caught in her throat. Ugh, you're so... You don't understand anything, do you? I already told you, you don't have to go announce it to the world like you're all self-important. You don't have to go announcing it to the world like you're all self-important. Pretty sure you never actually said that. I said that myself, mostly to myself. Natsuki must really hate me or something. Can't figure out if it's a win or a loss that she likes my poem. In any case, you still need to show me yours, right? Ugh, fine, I guess. Only because Monica will make me if I don't. And it's the Eagles one. Okay. Yeah. I told you that you weren't going to like it. I like it. What? Just be honest. I am. Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it? Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. People don't even take my writing seriously. Isn't that the point of poems for people to express themselves? Your writing style just wouldn't make your message any less valid. Yes, exactly. I like when it's easier to read, but hits you hard. Like this poem. Seeing everyone around you do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it. Yeah, I understand. But the other nice thing about simple writing is it puts more weight on the wordplay. Like I set up for a rhyme at the end, but made it fall flat on purpose. It helps bring out the feeling of the last line. So you did. Guess more went into it than I realized. It's what it means to be a pro. Bro. God. Glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here, did ya? Yeah, I guess not. Decided to humor her with that last comment. I don't really care how old everyone is, but if Natsuki's feeling proud, then I won't take it away from her.
Jesus, what was... Oh, God, there was so much wrong with that earlier.
Yuri. Were the skirts always blue? Yuri stares at the poem. A minute passes, more than enough time for her to finish reading. Sorry. I forgot to start speaking. It's fine. Don't force yourself. I'm not. I just need to put more thought into words. Hold on. Okay. This is your first time writing a poem, right? Yeah. Why do you ask? I'm just making sure. I guessed that it might be after reading through it. Ah, so it's that bad. No! Did I just raise my voice? I'm so sorry. Yuri buries her face in her hands. Couldn't help but notice that it's been several minutes and we haven't gotten anywhere. It might take Yuri a while to get used to new people. It's fine. Really didn't notice. What were you saying? Right, it's just that there are specific writing habits that are typical of new writers. And having been through that myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most notable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, you tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter and then form-fit the two together. The end result is that both the style and expressiveness are weakened. Once Yuri finds her train of thought, it's as if her demeanor has totally changed. Her stammering is completely quiet. She sounds like an expert. Of course, it's not something you can be blamed for. Wait a minute. Okay, the secret poem we got earlier was in relation to, I'm pretty sure, Yuri. What if the glitches are, too? Of course, it's not something you can be blamed for. There's so many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them. But getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take some time, but it all comes with practice and learning by example and trying new things. And I also hope that everyone in the club gives you valuable feedback. Natsuki can be a little biased, though. Biased? Ow. Well, never mind. I shouldn't be talking about people like that. Sorry. It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri's apologizing to herself, to me, or to Natsuki. You mind if I read your poem now? Please do.
I'd love to share my thought process behind it. Yuri smells dreamily, as if that's a rare opportunity for her. Which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't this supposed to be a literature club? Yeah, and it's the ghost under the light one. Last remaining street light. The light flickers, I flicker back. I'm sorry I have such terrible handwriting. What? No, believe me, it's better than mine. I write like a doctor with Parkinson's. I wasn't thinking about that at all. But it took you a long time to read. Ah. Well, I just don't read script very often. I actually think your handwriting is pretty. Eh? That's a relief. Wait.
Seems to like forcibly hold herself to a higher standard.
Yeah, that whole domestic abuse line might actually be about her.
That's a relief. Also, I liked the poem. Even though it's short, it was really descriptive. It wasn't too short. You usually write longer poems. Not at all. I'm really glad you liked it. I'll be honest. Since it's our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose. Are you into ghosts, Yuri? Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, Lydic. Really? I must have totally missed the point. Well, I suppose you did only glance over it, after all. But remember that poems often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost. Lingering in her past, remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past. And soon to be left with nothing. It's a lot more solemn putting it that way. I hadn't even thought of that. That's impressive. It's nothing, really. Well, it makes me happy that you think that. Just remember that it won't be long before you pick up on these things, too. Yeah, maybe you're right. I guess I'll have to keep trying. I'm counting on you.
This is Monica.
Hi, Lydic. Having a good time so far?
Yeah, I'd be having a better one if these heart palpitations would stop.
Yeah. Good. Glad to hear. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we could do better, you know, like making sure that club members don't kill themselves, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring these things up, okay? Alright, keep that in mind. Of course, be afraid to bring things up. I'm much better off just going with the flow until I'm more settled in. Anyway, want to share your poem with me? It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to. Don't worry, Lydic. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know? It's that sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true.
I hand Monica my poem.
Mm-hmm.
I like it, Lydic.
Really?
It's a lot cuter than I expected. I tend to do that sometimes. Oh, jeez.
No.
Gotta make me think it's of something that Suki would write. She's a good writer, too. So take that as a compliment. If you say so.
Yep.
If you're interested in Atsuki, then I could go, then always keep a snack on you. She'll cling to you like a puppy.
She does have a blood sugar problem, doesn't she?
Natsuki's dad doesn't give her lunch money or leave any food in the house, so she's in a fussy mood pretty often?
What?
But sometimes she just loses all of her strength and shuts down. Oh my god! Like earlier. That's not a blood sugar problem. But I think she's so small because her malnutrition is interfering with her adolescent growth. But hey, some guys are into petite girls too, you know? Sorry, just trying to look at the bright side.
There is not a bright side to that.
Oh my god! Domestic abuse was about her. Her dad is trying to starve her to death. Anyway, do you want to read my poem now? Don't worry, I'm not very good. You sound pretty confident for someone who claims to not be very good.
Well, that's because I have to sound confident. That doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know? See. Well, let's read it then. He wasn't looking at me. Confused, I frantically glanced at my surrounding, but my burned eyes could no longer see color. Are there other in this room? Are they talking? Or are they simply flat sheets of paper? The sound of frantic scrawling planks tricks on my ears. The room begins to crinkle, closing in on me. The air I breathe dissipates before it reaches my lungs. I panic. There must be a way out. It's right here. He's right there. It's right there. He's right there. Swallowing my fears, I brandish my pen. That was different from the other ones. Every single one of yours. Are they just flat pieces of paper? You're talking about the talk sprites. So what do you think? It's very freeform, if that's what you call it. Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback. It's okay. Yeah, that kind of style has gotten pretty popular nowadays. That is, lots of poems have been putting emphasis on the time between words and lines. Whenever performed out loud, it can be really powerful. What was the inspiration behind this one? Well, I'm not sure how to put it. I guess you could say I've had some kind of epiphany recently. You know, like an epiphany, that I'm just living in a fictional world, and that I'm looking out, screaming, unable to do anything. Sorry. It's been kind of influencing my poems a bit. An epiphany. Yeah, something like that. I'm kind of nervous to talk about deep stuff like that because it kind of comes on strong. It's kind of coming on strongly. Maybe after everyone is better friends with each other. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem or a story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. If you try so hard to make it perfect, then you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this. If you keep your pen in the same spot for too long, you'll just get a big dark puddle of ink. So just move your hand and go with the flow. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Whew. Guess that's everyone. Glance around the room. That was a little more stressful than I anticipated. It's as if everyone is judging me for my mediocre writing abilities. Even if they're just being nice, there's no way my poems stand up theirs. I'm not the only one that heard that flute, right? Like the way that flute was? This is a literature club, after all. I sigh. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into. Yeah, the room was tilted earlier! Across the room, Nonika is writing something in her notebook. My eyes land on Yuri Natsuki. They gingerly exchange pieces of paper, comparing their respective poems. As they read in tandem, I watch each of their expressions change. Natsuki's eyebrows furrow in frustration, meanwhile Yuri smiles sadly. What's with this language? Eh? Did you say something? Oh, it's nothing. Natsuki dismissively returns the poem to the desk with one hand. I guess you could say it's fancy. Ah, thanks. Yours is cute. Cute. Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up. How can that be cute? I know that. I just meant the language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice. Eh? You mean you'd have to try that hard to come up with something nice to say? Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all. Well, I do have a couple suggestions. Huh. If I was looking for suggestions, I would have asked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way. Monica liked it, and Leidig did too. So based on that, I gladly give you suggestions of my own. No mention of Sayori this time, yep. First of all, excuse me. I appreciate the offer, but I spent a long time establishing my writing style. I don't expect it to change anytime soon, unless, of course, I came across something particularly inspiring, which I haven't yet. Ugh! And Leidig liked my poem too, you know? He even told me he was impressed by it. Natsuki suddenly stands up. Oh! I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri. That's not what I... You're just... Yuri stands up as well. Maybe you're just jealous that Lytic appreciates my advice more than he appreciated yours. Huh? And how do you know he appreciated my advice more? Are you so full of- are you that full of yourself?
No.
If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out of my way to make sure everything I do is overly cutesy.
Ugh.
Well, you know what? I wasn't the one whose boob magically grew a size bigger as soon as Lytic started showing up. Natsuki!
Natsuki, that's a little- this doesn't involve you.
Taking out your insecurities on others like that?
Whoa!
You're really acting as young as you look. Me? Look who's acting like a wannabe edgy bitch, whoa!
Edgy?
Sorry that my lifestyle is too much for someone of your mental age to comprehend.
See?
Just saying that proves my point. Most people learn to get over themselves after they graduate middle school, you know. If you want to prove anything, then stop harassing others with your sickening attitude. You think you could even counterbalance your personality just by dressing and acting cute? The only cute thing about you is how hard you try.
Whoa! Be careful, you might cut yourself on that edge, Yuri. Oh, my bad. You already do, don't you?
Holy shit! Did you just accuse me of cutting myself? What the fuck is wrong with your head?
Oh, go on. Let Lytic hear everything you really think.
I'm sure he'll be head over heels for you after this.
Suddenly Yuri turns towards me as if she just noticed I was standing there.
Lytic? She's just trying to make me look bad.
It's not true. She started it.
Did I get my joy self try? Oh shit! So I can't save. Oh shit.
I can't pick Yuri.
Everything is... Oh God!
Hi, Monica!
Hey, Lytic. Why don't we step outside for a little bit, okay? Sorry about that. They really shouldn't have tried to get you involved. Probably better for us to stay out of this.
Go back inside once they're done yelling.
Some president I am, right? Can't even confront my own club members properly. Just wish I was able to be a little more assertive sometimes.
I mean...
I wasn't expecting that. But I never have it in me to put my foot down against others. You understand, right? Anyway... If this makes you want to spend less time with the others, then that's fine. I'll be happy to spend some time with you instead. Suddenly Natsuki runs out of the classroom. She quickly runs away. Oh dear. Well, it looks like they're done. I didn't mean it. Yuri is rocking back and forth on her inner desk with her palms on her forehead. Yuri?
Did it- holy shit, this is the first time we've had that expression with an I!
I didn't mean it.
I believe you.
I have no idea what Yuri might have said to Natsuki. Or did. Lytic, please don't hate me. Please. I'm not like this. There's something wrong with me today.
It's fine, Yuri.
We know you didn't mean it. Besides, I'm sure Natsuki will forget about it by tomorrow.
Completely.
Anyway, the meeting is over, so you can go home now if you want. Okay, I'm gonna... Everything's empty. I'm gonna save. This is all I have in me for now. If you enjoyed this, like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz, and I'll see you next time. Bye.